Let us solve some of the classwork of ratios. First one, the inverse ratio of 11 is to 50. Now, what is the inverse ratio of A is to B? Inverse ratio is nothing but B is to A. So, what is the inverse ratio of 11 is to 15? The inverse ratio of 11 is to 15 will be 15 is to 11. So, A is correct answer. Number two. The ratio of two quantities is 3 is to 4. So, this is our required ratio. If antecedent is 15, the consequent, so if the first term is 15, as we know, we can multiply and divide anything to the numbers of the ratio. We need to divide it in numerator also and in denominator also. If the antecedent is 15, means if the first term is 15, the consequent, that is second term, is what? Now, let me do this. Let me multiply 5 to this. Why I am multiplying 5 to this? Because antecedent they have given is 15 and 3 multiplied by 5 will be 15. So, my antecedent will become 15. And as I have multiplied 5 to numerator, I will have to multiply 5 to denominator also. So, I will be multiplying 5 at denominator also. This is not division. Multiplying 5 with denominator, I will be getting is to 40. So, antecedent, if in the same ratio, 3 is to 4 and 15 is to 40 is the same ratio. If the antecedent is 15, the consequent will be 40. 40, I think this is 40. D is correct answer. There is a printing mistake. This is 40. Number three, the ratio compounded of 4 is to 9. So, what is our first ratio to compound? 4 is to 9. I can write down 4 upon 9. And the duplicate ratio of 3 is to 4. Now, what is duplicate ratio of 3 is to 4 is 3 square is to 4 square, which is 9 is to 16. Alright, so our second ratio is 9 is to 16. And we want to find out ratio compound of these two ratios. What is ratio compound multiplied numerator multiplied denominator? You will be getting the answer. So the ratio compound of these two ratio will be 4 into 9. I have multiplied numerator and 9 into 16, which will be 1 4, which is 1 is to 4. So 1 is to 4 is A. So A is a correct answer. Let us do fourth one. The ratio compounded of duplicate ratio of 4 is to 5. Now, what is duplicate ratio of 4 is to 5? Is the 4 square upon 5 square. Triplicate ratio of 1 is to 3. What is triplicate ratio of 1 is to 3? Is 1 cube. 3 cube. Subduplicate ratio of 81 is to 256. Now, what is subduplicate ratio? Is under root. So, under root 81 will be 9 upon 256 under root will be 16. And subtriplicate ratio of 125 is to 512. So, it is cube root. 125 cube root will be 5. 512 cube root will be 6. Let me verify. 6 into 6 into 6 will be 216. So it is 8. Yes, 5 and 2 is 8. Subtriplicate ratio of 8 is 5 and 2. I want to find out a ratio compound of all this ratio. How many ratios are under consideration? 4. I want to find out a ratio compound of all this ratio. So, I need to multiply all this ratio. 4 fours are 16. 1 cube is 1. 9 is 9. 5 will remain 5. Divided by 5 fives are 25. 3 threes are 9. 3s are 27. 16 and 8. This will be 3, This will be 5. 16, 16 gets cancelled. In numerator, there is 1. In denominator, it is 5 into 3 into 8. So, it's 120. 1 divided by 120 is correct answer. Now, it is neither A, B, C. So, the correct answer is none of this, which is D answer. Question number 5. If A is to B is 3 is to 4. So, A I can take as 3. Please understand, whenever there is a ratio, if you are taking A as 3, B should be compulsorily taken as 4. Now, if you multiply, say, 2 to this 3, you will have to multiply 2 to this 4 also. Is it all right? So, it is in the smallest integer, 3 is to 4. So, we are not further reducing it. The value of 2A plus 3B is to 3A plus 4B. Now, it is very simple. Instead of A, I will be writing 4. Sorry. Instead of A, I will be writing 3. Instead of B, I will be writing 4. I will be getting answer. So, 2 into 3 plus 3 into 4 is to 3 into 3 plus 4 into 4, which is 6, 12 is 18 is to 9, 16 is 25. 18 is to 25. D is correct answer. Question number 6. To divide something in ratio, try to concentrate. Whenever we are dividing something in ratio, you need to understand this. Division of 324 between X and Y in the ratio of 11 is to 7. So how many rupees are in under consideration? 324. We want to divide this 324 rupees to A and B such that they should be divided in ratio of 11 is to 7. Now, what does this mean is, if there are 18 parts, how 18 parts? 11 plus 7. If there are 18 parts, 11 parts will go to A and 7 parts will go to B. If there are 18 parts, actually there are 324 rupees. But if there are 18 parts, 11 will go to A and 7 will go to B. So if there are 18 parts, one part will be how much? 324 divided by 18. It is 324 divided by 18 is 18. So per part will be 18. And A is getting how many parts? 11 parts. 11 into 18. Because he is getting 11 parts and one part contains 18 rupees. So this 2 are 18. You should not get confused. So 11 into 18, 198. And B is, he is getting 7 parts of 18 rupees. It is 126 rupees. This is 198 rupees. So both should be getting 198 rupees should be given to A. And what should be given to B is 126 rupees. Now, understand another way of calculating this. There are 324 rupees. A is given 11 parts out of 18 parts. Now, this is a shortcut. You don't have to think this much how many each part will be there. A is getting 11 out of 18. And B is getting, there are 324 rupees, he is getting 7 out of 18. The answer will remain same. It will be 198 and 126. So correct answer should be 198, 126 is not given in the option. D is a correct answer. Question number 7. Anand earns rupees 80 in 7 hours and Pramod earns rupees 90 in 12 hours. The ratio of their earnings is, now Anand is earning rupees 80. and Pramod is earning rupees 90. You will say, sir, ratio is 80:90. The answer is wrong. Why? This 80 rupees are in 7 hours. And this 90 rupees are in 12 hours. Now the ratio cannot be done. Why? Because this is in 7 hours, this is in 12 hours. You will say, sir, units are same. It is rupees, rupees. But understand, the commodity is not same. One earning is in 7 hours, another earnings is in 12 hours. So we need to modify that. What I am doing is, I am... So per hour rate, what will be per hour rate? It is rupees 80 divided by 7 is to rupees 90 divided by 12. So now whatever I am getting is per hour. Now what is it? 80 divided by 7 is 11.4285. And 90 divided by 12 is 7.5. So what is this ratio? It is 11.4285 divided by 7.5. 11.4285 divided by 7.5 is 1.5238. 1.5238. Now the answers are also given in ratios. Let me find out which ratio is 1.5238. Say A answer. What is A answer? It is 32 divided by 21. Which is 1.5238, 1.5238. I have got in first instance only correct answer. So A is correct answer. Question number 8. The ratio of two numbers is 7:10. And the difference is 105. The numbers are. Now as the question and answer format is of MCQ, we are already having the option, and this question should be solved with options because it is easy. First, I'm giving you some long cut method, and then I'll give you a very easy method to solve it. First, what is the difference between this two number is 105? What is difference between this two number will be 105. 290 minus 185 is 105. So the difference is 105 in all three numbers, right? So any can be correct answer, A, B or C. Now let us deduce this ratio. This is divided by 5. So 5, 40:61. This cannot be further reduced. The ratio is not 7:10. Is it all right? Similarly, I can find out of this. Similarly, I can find out of this. And believe me, the answer over here will be 7:10. Now, what is the shortest method to solve it? Once we have understood that the difference of A, B and C, D is none of this. So A, B and C, the difference is 105. So what is the shortcut? Try to concentrate. How I will find out the ratio? See, I am knowing that the correct answer is 7:10. Let me divide this by 7 and divide this by 10. If both numbers are equal, it is my correct answer. So 200 divided by 7 and 305 divided by 10. Those are not equal numbers. So ultimately that this ratio is not 7:10. I can verify whether this ratio is 7:10 by dividing numerator by 7, dividing denominator by 10. If the number which is my answer is equal, then the ratio of this two number is 7:10. See this, divided by 7 divided by 10. So this is 185 divided by 7. It is 26.42, is not equal to 29. So this ratio is not also 7:10. Let me verify this, 7:10. Now this is 245 divided by 7 is 35. And this is also 35. It is not 35:35. Now try to concentrate what I just did. So this ratio is 7:10 because this answer is also 35 and this answer is also 35. Now what I have done, try to concentrate. What is the ratio? 245 is to 350. Is it all right? So if you divide this number by 35, if you divide this number by 35, the answer will be 7 is to 10. So what is the answer? 7. What is the answer? 10. Right? Now what I did while doing the shortcut is I took the 7 over here. Over here. And 10 over here. So what I did? 245 divided by 7. 350 divided by 10. If my answer is equal, because we know if the numerator and denominator are divided by the same number, then the ratio remains same. If the answer is equal answer, and here it was 35. So I got a correct answer C. In short, what to do? Whenever you want to know if some number is in ratio or not, a particular ratio or not, say I want to check whether 20 is to 25. Is the ratio of 4 is to 5 or not? What I need to do? Divide it by 4, divide it by 5. This is 5, this is 5. If both numbers are equal, then this particular ratio, that is 20 is to 25, is equal to 4 is to 5. So any big number, any say 4 digit, 5 digit, 6 digit number, if you want to find out whether it is in particular ratio or not, divide it by antecedent by numerator and consequent by denominator. If you get the equal number, that means that particular ratio is in that particular number is numbers ratio. Big numbers ratio is in that particular short form ratio. So this type of question should always be solved in this manner. Once again, let me clarify what we did is I wanted to find out whether 245 divided by 350 is in ratio of 7 is to 10 or not. I divided it by 7, I divided it by 10, I got 35. If this both numbers are equal, then this are in ratio of 7 is to 10. Question number 9. PQR are three cities. So there are three cities, P, Q and R. The ratio of average temperature between P and Q is 11 is to 12. And that of P and R is 9 is to 8. Now, whenever this type of three cities are given or any three product is given and ratio between two is given, how to solve the answer is very simple. I can find out the ratio of temperature between P, Q and R. But what is the problem? Your P is 11 and your P is 9. In both the cases, we are having P, but they are separate numbers. So can I make it a same number? The answer is yes. 11 into 9. But when I do first term multiplied by 9, I'll have to multiply this also by 9. In this ratio of also, what was this ratio? 11 is to 12. Now I have done 11 multiplied by 9 is to 12 multiplied by 9. Second ratio is 9 is to 8. Now I want to make P equal. So I am multiplying 11 over here. So this will also become 99. This will also become 99. But if I multiply 11 over here, now which is this ratio? It is 9 is to 8 between P and R. So this will be also multiplied by 11. So what will be this ratio? 99 is to 108. What will be this ratio? 99 is to 88. So ratio between P, Q and R will be 99. Now see this, both are same. So if I can use 99 as P, I can use 108 as Q. And as I am using 99 as P, I can use 88 as R. So ratio between this three cities, P is to Q is to R, is 99 is to 108 is to 88. Now what they are asking us? The ratio between the average temperature between Q and R is 108 is to 88. 108 is to 88. Now this is 4 2s 8, 4 7s are 28, 4 2s 8, 4 2s 8, this is 27 is to 22, so B is correct answer. Let us now solve question number 10. If p is to q is a subduplicate ratio of p minus x square is to q minus x square, then what is the value of x square? Now, rather than solving it, I will be practically finding out answer by trial and error method. What is it? I will try to solve with A, I will try to solve with option B, I will try to solve with option C. Whatever answer I get as a correct answer, I'll tick mark it. If I am unable to solve in A, B and C, I will mark D as an correct option. So let me first try out A. Sir, can't we do C, B and A? You can follow any sequence, but normally what I do is I start with A, then B and then C. So what is given in the question is subduplicate ratio of this. Now, what is the subduplicate ratio of this is P minus X square upon Q minus X square under root is equal to P upon Q. This is what is actually given. And they are telling us then what is the value of x square. Now let us assume x square is equal to p upon p plus q. Then under root p minus x square. Instead of x square, I will be writing p plus q divided by under root q minus p upon p plus q. Let me solve this. It is p square plus pq minus p upon p plus q under root upon pq plus q square minus p upon p plus q under root. Now, I cannot go ahead except to cancel this. My answer is not coming p divided by q. So, let me try out another option, that is B option. Now, for B option, let me again write down p minus what is x square q upon p plus q, and I need to find out subduplicate ratio is this. So this will be my numerator for this. Q minus q upon p plus q under root, because I want subduplicate ratio, and answer of this should be p divided by q. So if I solve this, it is p square plus pq minus q upon p plus q under root. This is my numerator. Denominator will be q square plus pq minus q upon p plus q under root. Here also except this, nothing can be cancelled. B is not a correct answer. Let me try out C. It is p minus x square. Instead of x square, value of x square, I am writing pq upon p plus q. This is value of x square. Under root, because my answer is subduplicate ratio. Divided by under root q minus x square. Instead of x square, I am writing pq upon p plus q. Answer of this should be p divided by q, then c is the correct answer. Let me solve it. It is p square plus pq minus pq upon p plus q divided by under root q square plus pq minus pq upon p plus q. Here PQ can get cancelled. PQ can get cancelled. This PQ can also get cancelled. This is under root P square upon under root Q square. Under root P square is P. Under root Q square is Q. The answer is P by Q. So value of X square in this is nothing but PQ divided by P plus Q. C is a correct answer. Question number 11. Now, this is a very generic question. The number which when subtracted from each of the term 19 is 231. Sir, can we subtract anything from numerator and denominator? No. But they are just asking us if one number is subtracted from first term as well as second term, the same number, then the ratio should be 1:4. What is my target ratio? It should be 1:4. Again, trial and error method. If 15 is subtracted from this and 15 is also subtracted from this, this will be 4. This will be 16. 4:16 is nothing but 1:4. I will divide it by 4. Divided by 4 is 1:4. So if 15 is subtracted from first term as well as 15 is subtracted from second term, my ratio will change to 1:4. So 15 is a correct answer. A is a correct answer. Once I have got the answer, I will not test B, C and D. This is question number 11. 12. Daily earnings of two persons are in ratio of 4:5. And their daily expenses are is in ratio of 7:9. So in earnings are in the ratio of 4:5 and expenditure are in the ratio of 7:9. If each person saves 500 per day, so both person A as well as B, one as well as two, their daily earnings are, they are asking questions of earnings. Again, a good method is trial and error method. They are asking us question of earnings. Earnings should be in the ratio of 4:5. Here the earnings is in ratio of 4:5. Here the earnings is not in the ratio of 4:5. Here the earnings is in ratio of 4:5. So correct answer can be C or can be A. It cannot be B because in B option earnings are not in the ratio of 4:5. It is in the ratio of 5:4. Let us test A. If my earnings is 40, say for Mr. A or first person, and for Mr. B is 50 rupees. What is the savings? Earnings minus expenses. Now try to concentrate. A cannot be a correct answer. Why? I'll tell you. If expenditure of, earnings of A is 40, expenditure cannot be more than 40. And so savings can never become 50. They are saying savings are 50 per day. Savings can never become 50. So if your earnings is 40, your savings cannot become 50. So even A is not a correct answer. Let us try out C. If my earnings are 400 for A and 500 for B, sir, how to check whether it is a correct answer or not? Try to concentrate. What is given? Savings is 50, right? If savings is 50, what will be expenditure for A? 350. This is expense for A is 350. Now it is given that expenditures are in ratio of 7:9. If expense is in ratio of 7:9 and if the expense of A is 350 rupees, then expenditure of Mr. B, second one, very simple cross multiplication. इफ 350 इज इक्वल टू 7, व्हाट इज इक्वल टू 9, देन इट विल बी 350 इंटू 9 डिवाइडेड बाई 7 विल बी 450. सो एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ बी विल बी 450 रुपीज. लेट मी राइट डाउन एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ बी एज 450 रुपीज. आर दिस इन रेशियो ऑफ 7 इज टू 9? द आंसर इज येस. सो आई एम गोइंग इन अ करेक्ट डायरेक्शन. वॉट विल बी सेविंग्स ऑफ बी? इनकम माइनस एक्सपेंडिचर इज योर सेविंग. सो सेविंग्स ऑफ बी इज ऑल्सो रुपीज 50. So this are earnings of A and B. If A is earning 400 rupees, B is earning 500 rupees. If their earnings are in the ratio of 4 is to 5, expenditure is in ratio of 7 is to 9. And so they will both save 50 rupees each. C is a correct answer. We are going to 30. The ratio between the speed of two trains is 7 is to 8. If the second train runs 400 kilometers in 5 hours, the speed of a first train is? It is a very simple question. What is the ratio between speed of two trains? Say two trains A and B. The ratio is 7 is to 8. If the second train runs 400 kilometers in 5 hours. Now, what is 400 kilometers in 5 hours? Is 80 kilometers per hour. How I have found out 400 kilometers in 5 hours is 80 kilometers per hour. This is a speed. Speed is normally measured in per hour terms. Also, we have understood unit, every base of the ratio should be same. So for A also, I will be getting answer per hour. Is it all right? Now it is very simple. The ratio is 7 is to 8. B speed is 80 kilometers per hour. Just do cross multiplication. If 8 is 80 kilometers per hour, 70 is 70 kilometers per hour. You can watch this. This is per hour. Per hour, kilometers, kilometers, 7 is to 8. And so A is traveling at a speed of 70 kilometers per hour. 70 kilometers per hour is C option. C will be the correct answer. This is question number 13.